Good morning, dear students. Welcome to the math session. Okay, so already we have learned the basic things and introduction about the plane wave numbers. In the plane wave numbers, already we have solved the exercise number 1.1 and 1.2. The exercise number 1.3 is totally dependent upon the divisibility test. Okay, today we are going to learn that is divisibility test. Okay, so you people have learned in your earlier classes about the division. So division is nothing but the number which is divisible by the given number or not. So all you people have learned about the 2-digit numbers and 3-digit numbers. So in Yale standard, the question is having, otherwise each question is having more than 6 digits, like a lakhs digit places. So how to find out the divisibility test within a short time? Okay, the numbers are, first one, let us take the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So these are our basic numbers. So for example, if you are dividing a number, we'll take, otherwise we'll use these numbers. So each number having the own divisibility rules. So for example, what is the common number? Means each and every number is divisible by 1. So there is no rules about number 1, but the second number is what? 2. First one, divisibility test of 2. First one, how to take the divisibility test of number 2? So number 2 has its own divisibility rules. First one, how to find out the number, otherwise how to take the number which is divisible by number 2. The first one, first rule, the unit place should be even number, correct? The rule is what? The first rule, the first principle, or the first rule is what? The unit place should be even number. For example, we start from the single digit numbers. 2 is there, so 2 is divisible by 2, yes. So one more number, 12. 12 is also divisible by 2. How? 2 ones are 2, 6 are 12. Next, 3 digit number, 124. So this is also divisible by what? 2. Next, 1, 2, 2, 6. 4 digit number, the last digit is what? Even. So it is divisible by what? 2. Next, 1, 2, 2, 2, 5, 6. How many digits are there? 5 digits are there, but the unit digit is what? Even number. So this is also divisible by what? 2. Next, 1, 5, 6, 7, 8, 6. 6 digit numbers are there, as well as what is the final number? Final number is even, so this is also divisible by what? Number 2. The divisibility test of 2 says the unit number, otherwise the unit place should be even number. Correct? Unit is 10. What is the unit place? 2. So it is divisible by what? 2. Unit is 100. 4 is even number. Unit is 100,000. 6 is there. That is also divisible by 2. Units tens, 100,000, 10,000. What is the unit place? 6. This also divisible by what? 2. The rule of the 2 is what? In the given number, the unit place should be even. Okay, I'll give one more example. 1, 2, 2, 2, 5. So what is the unit place here? 5. So this is not divisible by what? 2. Understand me? Last digit is what? 5 is there, so this is not divisible by 2. Second one, the number should be the number should be multiple of 2. Look here children carefully. Usually test of 2. The first rule is what? The unit place should be even number. Here the first rule is totally different from what? Unit place. Second one, the number should be multiple of 2. Like 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6, 2 fours are 8, 2 fives are 10, 2 6 are 12, 2 sevens are 14, etc. etc. If the multiple of 2 is also divisible by 2, these two are the rules to take the divisibility test of 2. Understanding? Okay, just pause the video, write down these two steps. So next I will go to the next number. So divisibility test of 1 is 4. All the numbers are divisible by 2. Divisibility test number 2. 2 is nothing but having 2 rules. First one is unit place should be even number. Second, the number should be multiple of 2. So along with the examples I have explained here, so you can take another example also. Next one is divisibility test of 3. So, for example, if you are having a number, whether it is the last digit is even, we can easily say the number which is divisible by 2. So, what are the rules come under the divisibility test of number 3? The first one is the multiple of 3 are divisible by 3. The number which is multiple of 3. For example, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12, etc. These are the what of multiple of 3. So these are automatically divisible by what? Number 3. The number which is a multiple of 3 suddenly is divisible by 3. For example, 30. 30 is nothing but 3 tens are, yes? 30 is there. 3 tens are 30. 33. 3 elevens are, yes? So these two are divisible by what? 3. Means the first rule of the divisibility test of 3 is the multiple of 3 are divisible by what? 3. Second rule, if we add all the numbers or digits, the result should be multiple of 3. So second one is what the most important. If we add all the numbers or digits, the result should be multiple of 3. For example, look here. So this was one of the important rule to find out the divisibility test of 3. First one, 12 is there. How many digits we are having? 2 digits. Unit and tens. How to find out 1 plus 2? What is your answer? 3. Means if we add these two digits, we should get the multiple of 3. Multiple of 3 means what? 3 ones are 3. If we get the result like this, this number is 100% divisible by what? 3. Celebrate one number. So 124. Correct? First one, what will do? 1 plus 2 plus 4. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 4, 7. Now check out, 7 is there in multiple of 3? No. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9. So, 7 is not divisible by 3. Next one, we'll take one more number. 1, 3, 6. Otherwise, 1 plus 3, 4, 135 you can take? Yes. 135. How to do? 1 plus 3 plus 5. Correct? So you can take your own numbers also, no problem. 1 plus 3 is what? 4. 4 plus 5 is what? 9. So what I am telling, if we add these digits, we should get the multiple of 3. Look here, 3 was a 3, so 7 is not there in the number, table number 3. But 9, 3 was a 3, 3 was a 6, and 3 3 is a 9. So this type of number is completely divisible by 3. Clear? Next one. One more number we can take. 1, 2, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So total how many digits are there? 7 digits are there. Let us check out whether the number is divisible by 3 or no. Okay, what to do? What is the process? 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 5. Understanding? 1, 2, 2, 5, 6, 7, 5. Means units, tens, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, 12 lakhs, 25,000, 625 is divisible by number 3 or no. Okay, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 5, 10, 10 plus 6, 16, 16 plus 7, 16 plus 4, 20. 20 plus 3, 23, 23 plus 5, 28. Correct? Now check out the multiple. 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15, 3 6s are 18, 3 9, 3 7s are 21, 3 8s are 24, 3 9s are 27, 3 10s are 30. So this number is not divisible by 3. Understanding? Divisible by 3 is what? First one, the multiples of 3. Multiples of 3 is nothing but in the table of 3. Second one, if we add all the numbers or digits. So, if, for example, if you take the examples like a 12, what we have to do? Just we have to add 1 and 2. So, what is our answer? 3. So, this 3 is multiple of what? 3. Next one. 124, I have given 135 also. Next, these are there. In the exercise, we will solve, but these are the examples of divisibility test of 3. These two are the basic rules. Clear? 1 is over, 2 is over, 3 is also over. Shall we go for the fourth one? Yes. Divisibility test of 4. Okay, I'll draw this. The divisibility test of 4 is one of the important divisibility test. Test in the sense is having its own different rules. Okay, let us discuss. First one. So as you know, divisibility test of 4. Rule number 1. The number should be, this is a common rule. Number should be multiple of 4. The first rule is divisibility test of 4. The number should be multiple of 4. For example, the examples are 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12, 4 4s are 16. 4, 5 is 20, 14, dash, dash, dash. Means you can take the multiples like a 4. So these are 100%. Because of these are the multiples of what? 4, automatically divisible by 4. Now come to the second rule. What is the second rule? This is one of the important rules. The rule is what? In exercise number 1, means in 1.1, what we have solved? The following, write the following in generalized form. The same thing will come here. Means, first one, write each digit in generalized form. Generalized form. Correct? Otherwise, expandable form. Understanding? So, rule number 2 is what? Write each digit in generalized form. For example, we are having a number. Example number 1. So, we start from the each digit. Single digit number 4. What is this? Divisible by 4. Next one. So, these are up to 4 and 8. These are the single digits. These two numbers are divisible by 4. 4 ones are 4 and this is 4 digit. So, let me go for the 2 digit numbers. For example, 2 digit number 12. 12 is what? Automatically is a multiple of what? 4. So, this is 100% divisible by 4. Next, we will take one more number. What is that? 34. So, let us start the taking the multiples of 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12, 4 fives are 20, 4 six are 24. Correct? 4 sevens are 28, 4 eights are 32, 4 nines are 36. 34 is not there. Correct? By checking the counting of multiples also, we can find out whether the number is divisible by 4 or no. But the number is 34 is there. One more method is there. How to find out? Units, tens. 3 into, otherwise, 3 into 10 plus 4 into 1. So 3 tens are what? 30 plus 4. Now check out each place value is the multiple of 3 or no. Understanding? 30. So 30 is not there in the table number 4. So the total number is not divisible by 4. What I'll explain? Look at clearly. 34. So write the 34 in generalized form. 3 in tens place, 4 in ones place. 30 into 10, 30. 4 ones are 4. Later on, check each number like this. 30. So 4 ones are 4. This number is divisible by 4. But 30 is not there in the table of 4. That's why it's not divisible by 4. Clear up? This is 2 digit number. So let us take one more 3 digit number. Okay. So now tell me what to take. 124. The 3 digit number is what? 124. Let us find out whether it is divisible by 4 or no. How to take 1 into 100. 1 into what? 100 plus 2 into 10 plus 4 into 1. So this is the one of the important rule to check down the number is divisible by 4. So 124 is there, 100 ones are 100, 2 tens are 20, 4 ones are 4. Now check each and every one. 25 fours are, this is also multiple of 4. 4 fives are 20, 4 ones are 4. The total number is what? Divisible by 4. Clear? Okay. I'll go on more comment here, one more number. 1336. 1336. Okay, how to do? 1000 directly also you can write. Next term, 300. Next term, 30 plus 6. 1000. 254 is a 1000. Correct? 252 is a 500. 253 is a 2, what is that? 750, 254 is a 1000. 1000 is divisible by what? 4. 300. In table number 3, 300 is there. So this is not divisible. 30 is also not there. 6 is also not there. Totally, this number is not divisible by 4. Understanding? If you are having the multiples, no problem. If we get the number like a 4 digits, 5 digits or 6 digits, we have to take the number in generalized form. Later on, we have to check each and every number which is the multiple of 4 or no. Later on, if single number which is not divisible by 4 in the sense, whole number is not divisible by 4. Understood? So we have checked here, these three numbers are multiple of 4. This one, this total number is divisible by 4. But here, 1336 is there, 1000 plus 300 plus 30 plus 6. So these are only 1000 is the multiple of 4, but 300, 30 and 6 are not a multiple of 4. That's why this whole number is not divisible by 4. Understood, children? Okay. Shall I now we will learn the multiple of 5. Otherwise, the divisibility rule of 5. Yes. 4 is over. Now coming to the 5. Divisibility test of 5. The rule number 1. Same formula. What's the first formula? What's the first rule? The number should be what? Multiple of 5. Correct? So this is a common rule for each and every number. The number should be multiple of 5. Example, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20, 5 fives are 25, etc. etc. 50 and remaining. These are what must and should. This rule by 5. What is rule number 2? The unit digit should be 0 or 5. So I'm saying that the unit digit should be 0 or 5. So this is a special rule in the digit number 5. For example, 5 is there. What is the unit digit? 5. So this is what? Divisible by 5. Why? 5 ones are 5. Second, 10. What is the unit digit? 0. And this is a multiple of what? 5. So automatically it is divisible by 5. How many number I'll take? 100. What is the unit digit? 0. So this is divisible by what? 5. Next, 105. So what is the rule? Unit digit should be 5. 5 is there. 5 plus 10, 5 plus 5. Means it's also divisible by what? 5. So one more number. 1005. So what is the final digit? 5 is there. So this is also divisible by 5. One more number I'll give you. 10006. What is the unit digit? 6. So this number is not divisible by what? 5. Correct? Simple rule. Simple rule is answer. This totally depends upon what? Unit digit. The unit digit should be 0 or 5. Clear, children? Okay. So just take your own examples, apply the rule, find out whether the number is divisible by the given number or no. So already I have explained 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the next session I will take 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Clear? So in your textbook, it's like 2, 4, 8, 5, 10, 3, 6, 9. But I am explaining each and every number and regarding rule based on each number. So if you have doubts, I have given a number in the first session, just give on call during 5 to 7 p.m. Thank you, dear children. Have a nice day.